Hi everyone, I'm Corbin Rides, and today we're going to do a detailed Anthurium Care video. So over here we have two Anthurium on Anthuriums. This is a nice pink one and this is like a peachy coloured one. And here is my Anthurium Clarinervium. This is my first Anthurium Clarinervium. I recently purchased a second plant and I did an unboxing video last week. I will put the link up in the video for you guys so you guys can see how I unboxed my plant. Anthuriums enjoy bright indirect light without any direct sunlight. In quite a few of the houses where I stayed in the past, they had kind of sheer muslin curtains in front of the windows, which was absolutely perfect for my Anthuriums because it meant that it blocked the harsh rays of the sun and my plants kind of, you know, got this like bright diffused type of light, which was absolutely perfect for them, and it enabled them to flower throughout the year. So I had my Anthurium Andraeanum like practically in flower throughout the year, and that is something that is possible with Anthurium Andraeanum. I've always liked my Anthuriums to dry out slightly in between waterings, especially my Anthurium on a Anthurium. But I have noticed with my Clarinervium and my bird's nest Anthuriums that they don't like to dry out too much in between waterings. So as a general rule, I aim to water my plants about once a week and during the summer months when it's really hot.
Hi, Gracie.
And during the summer months when it's really hot, I, you know, sometimes do it twice a week, like depending if the plant is in a clay pot, which would dry out like quicker, if the plant is semi root bound. That's all things I take into consideration when I decide when to water my Anthuriums. So Anthuriums love humidity to be around 50 to 60%. I use a humidifier in my grow space with my Anthuriums, and I also measure the humidity on a small eve temperature and humidity meter. I found that the Anthurium on Anthurium can tolerate lower humidity levels, and the more velvet Anthuriums like Anthurium Clarinervium, like the Queen Anthurium, Anthurium Magnificum, they like higher levels of humidity. So I water my Anthurium about once a week. That works really well with my Anthurium on Anthurium, but with my Anthurium Clarinervium and my bird's nest Anthuriums, they like to stay constantly moist but not soggy. A good idea is to actually keep your Anthuriums under the sink, similar to how you would water an orchid and allow the water to just run through the pot and touch your plant's roots, but not like keep them to be too soggy and standing in water. I found that that's really important with Anthuriums because they also grow in a semi-epiphytic way in the wild, where their roots would be exposed to air movement and not be in a soggy waterlogged medium. So other ways to increase the humidity around your plants, if you don't want to use a humidifier, is to place your plant on a tray of pebbles, and you put your plant on the pebbles. Make sure that your plant is not standing in the water, so it's not making contact with the pot. And what will happen is, as the water evaporates, it increases the humidity around your plant. So I fertilize my Anthuriums using a universal houseplant fertilizer, like this one. And I've actually found that this works pretty well on my foliage Anthuriums. And on my flowering Anthuriums, I prefer to use a orchid fertilizer. And that really helps them to produce these like flowers all throughout the year. And then I also use an organic fertilizer. This is a tea made from worm castings, and it has lots of macro and micronutrients in there, and a whole bunch of like real organic goodness for your Anthuriums. So I've fertilized my plants about twice a month, and I don't really make a differentiation between summer or winter, because I found that my plants grow and flower continuously throughout the year. So these fertilizers, they come with a recommended dosage on the back, and it's half of this cup at the top mixed with a liter of water. And this one, because it's an organic fertilizer, you can't really over fertilize your plants. So I use about, I think, 2 teaspoons of this in a liter of water. Oh, and the other thing I want to say is that you can also use these fertilizers as a foliar spray. So you can put it at the same dosage into a spray bottle and spray your plants over the leaves, and that helps your plants to absorb some of those nutrients through the leaves. So propagating your anthuriums is extremely easy to do using stem cuttings. I did do a short propagation video a while ago. I'll put the link up in the screen for you guys. Now I'll show you guys how I did that with this plant. So if I just move this one over and move my fertilizers out of the way. So if you guys can see over here, there's a small little plantlet coming up. And as long as the stem that you're using has aerial roots on it, it will root if you place it in a jar of water. I'm actually gonna take this piece off to show you guys. And here I have a jar and some water. I'm just gonna fill that up a bit. And then I'm just gonna use my scissor. So I'm just gonna take a piece as close to the mother plant as possible and just snip it off as close to the plant as I can. Someone commented on one of my videos and asked if you can propagate anthuriums using a stem and a leaf. And you can't do that because if you put this, I'm gonna just take this leaf off actually, because it's bent at the top. So if you had to put this in a glass of water, it's not going to do anything for you. You really need a piece of stem with the roots on it. So now I'm going to place this cutting into my jar. So what you want is that you want your cutting to just sit almost in the water, but not be completely submerged in water. So part of the stem must still stick out above. So you can keep this cutting in here for a few months when you see new roots starting to form. My other cutting that I had, my previous video, has actually started to grow new roots, and I'll actually put that in a new video for you guys where I pot that plant up. But they're really easy to root like this. I know some people like to just pot them up immediately into soil, but I prefer to go test root and go with the water propagation. So I'm just gonna move this plant out of the way so we can do the repotting of the other one. So this plant, this is a pink Anthurium Andraeanum. And if I take this plant out, you can see it's become quite pot bound and grown quite a bit. So it is in desperate need of a repot. So now I've made a nice little workspace. I'm gonna use a mixture of orchid bark, coco coir, and sphagnum moss. So it's a really fast draining, airy, and open mix that will allow lots of air movement around the roots of my plant and keeps them really healthy. So I'm gonna show you guys what I mean when I say that this plant is really pot bound. You can see how tightly compressed these roots are. It's actually grown in the pattern of the bottom of the pot. So this plant was in need of a repot. So I'm just gonna kind of neaten it up a bit whilst I'm here. Let's take off any of these older leaves and stuff in the bottom. So place it over there. I'm going to start off by putting some media in the bottom of my pot. So again, I'm using a clay pot for this plant. Clay tends to dry out faster than plastic, so for me that's actually ideal. so I know that my plant's not going to be too waterlogged. And so now I just check that the level is a bit too high. So just like out a bit. Because you don't want your anthurium to be planted too high in the pot, because I actually have an anthurium upstairs, my, I think, anthurium green jaguar, that's planted too high in the pot. So now every time when I water my plant, it runs off the side of the pot. So I always need to put the plant in the shower to make sure that it's completely saturated. Okay, so that looks fine to me. So now I'm going to kind of fill in the sides. And as far as like pests and diseases go, I haven't really noticed that any pests are very prone to being on anthuriums, apart from mealybugs or scurf. But whenever I have any pests with my plants, I just immediately hit them hard and continuously. And that usually takes like care of it. And anthuriums are also quite resilient plants, so it's going to take a heavy infestation of pests to take your plant down. If you have any anthuriums at home that are not blooming, I've actually found that the biggest reason that anthuriums are not blooming would be because of light conditions. Because I've seen so many people, when they bring their anthurium home, are tempted to place it in dark corners or in areas of a room where it looks nice, you know, but it's like not the light levels that your plant actually needs. Because an anthurium will, even in like medium light, it will still push out leaves and grow like very lusciously, but it's not going to produce like flowers. They really need that bright indirect light in order to flower continuously and throughout the year. And I can actually remember reading an article in an Afrikaans newspaper like years ago about a woman who had an anthurium anthurium that was always almost on death's door, and then she moved apartments, and then she said in a new apartment, then suddenly the plant like came alive and started to produce like flowers like continuously. And it was because she moved the plant into a whole different location, and perhaps she didn't even realize, you know, that she moved the plant into an area of stronger light conditions. So it also takes some experimentation with anthuriums. I've been like growing anthuriums since I've been a child. I got my first anthurium when I was about 12 years old. And obviously I killed it. And that's the thing that a lot of people, I think, don't understand about houseplants, is that I have, you know, like great success at the moment with plants. Now I have plants all over my house. But to have like gotten to that point, I had to kill a lot of plants to get the knowledge and the skills and to learn from those plants as to what to do and what not to do. So yeah, my repotting is done. My plant looks secure in its new home. I might need to stake this plant a bit because it is like getting a bit tall. And then also just give it a drink of water so the plant can settle into the new media and settle into the pot. When you do this, you must just be careful to, after like 10 minutes, to check that there's no water in the bottom of the container, because like I said previously, anthuriums don't like to stand in the water. So I hope that you enjoyed this anthurium care video. If you guys have any tips on how you grow your anthuriums, please leave them in the comment section below. I'd love to hear them. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and also please remember to subscribe and hit the notification button to make sure that you don't miss any of my future videos.